Oh, thank you. Thank you, Kat. Right. Hey, everybody. Lineater here, and welcome to another healthy mukbang. I have prepared this wonderful feast for me here. This simple salad from tomatoes and greens. It's very simple, very delicious, and it's very nutritious. What's the most important in it? Because it has all the vitamins, minerals, all the stuff you need. And then I have my wonderful scrambled eggs, prosciutto, fungi, and all sorts of greens in them. Like, we'll see if it's gonna be tasty because it's so full of greens, but hopefully it is. And then I have my salmon steak waiting for me under the foil so it doesn't get cold by the time I get to it. Overall, this little feast here is about 1400 calories. I'm going OMAD today, so one meal a day. So this will still keep me in quite a caloric like deficit by the end of it. Anyways, this food just looks and tastes delicious, I'm sure, but first things first, before I go right into it, my prayer and affirmations ritual. Thank you, God, for this wonderful day, for this wonderful opportunity to live. Thank you, God. Glory to God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, for this wonderful meal, for this food. Now this food will be to my benefit. My body is strengthened in the name of Jesus. My body grows stronger in the name of Jesus. My muscles grow in the name of Jesus. My fat diminishes in the name of Jesus. I prosper. I achieve success in the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Yeah, let's dive right into this. Yeah, I try to make best of what's possible. This is the final day here in Tula. The final day I stream. Tomorrow we will wrap things up and then next day we move back to St. Petersburg. And finally I will be back at my home, at my flat, at my apartment, where I can cook all sorts of delicious stuff. I have all my ingredients, all my kitchen utensils. Unfortunately, since my wife has celiac disease, we have to be gluten-free, and so we also have to carry our like stuff with us, because if we arrive at some kitchen and like we try to cook there with the utensils and the kitchenware it has, it might very well like be contaminated with gluten, and not everything can be washed. Like some scratches and stuff can contain gluten in them, so we better take our stuff with us. So we have to carry all the utensils, and so obviously we cannot carry like all of them. That would be several bags. Yes, I'm from Russia. I live in St. Petersburg. That's like the second largest city. But we are visiting my wife's parents here in Tula, and it's way low tech. Here, way lower touch, way smaller apartment, but I do what I can to manage to still have delicious, diverse foods. To enjoy. So yeah, continuing the last talk about motivation, I want to actually touch today about how to find your motivation, like to lose weight, to be fit, to be in a proper body. Because I am constantly asked, like, oh, like, how do I do it better? Like, how do I do it more easily? Like, oh, what's the diet you recommend to get like gains quickly, to get like loss faster? Like to get rid of this fat, what's the easiest way? And people misunderstand that it's not about that. It's not about the tricks and the tips. It's about the motivation first and foremost. Thank you very much for following. Yeah. Actually, it's very good in St. Petersburg. The city is beautiful because basically it was built from scratch. Like Peter the Great, he he was almost like an usurper to the throne. So he was a king who basically took the throne by force, and so he wasn't really supported by all the royalty, all the like aristocracy. So he just picked up and went from the capital of Moscow to a swamp and basically built a city right there from scratch on a swamp. And like he invited all these European architects and artists to make the city, to design it. And so yeah, St. Petersburg is a very beautiful city because it was like artificially constructed to be a masterpiece. It's an interesting story. And then like the capital went back to Moscow. So now we have like two capitals, two different designed capitals, and both are very like rich in architecture and stuff. It's actually great. Never tried basil in a salad. It's actually quite tasty. Like, it really is. Really tasty. Like, I think I'm gonna be adding basil to my salad more now. It really adds this very interesting note to overall. Yep, Leningrad is basically all this communist stuff. So the communism is about like people being in power. And so they renamed the streets, they renamed the... No, it's no, no problem. They renamed the streets and they named the cities, all this stuff, like to a street of like demonstration, a street of the people, a street of like Karl Marx, Lenin, whatever. And so the same is with cities. They renamed many cities to like these Marxist and Leninist names and ideologies, like Stalingrad, Leningrad, and so on and so forth. So it's like, then obviously when the communism was thrown away, now it went back, and now we restored some of the names, original names, to the like to the streets, to the cities. Not all of them, because that's also part of our history now, but like most of them, we kind of restored. So yeah, St. Petersburg went back to St. Petersburg after being Leningrad for 100 years. This is like a chill talk, so we can talk different topics. But what I wanted to touch is that, as I said, people ask like all these like questions. People think like what stops them from achieving their fitness goals is like they don't know certain tips or tricks. Like if they would like have this one tip or trick, it would be easy. But it's not like that. It's never like that. It's never like that actually in any field. Like people also try to make money this way. They go like, what's one trick to make money? Or like, what's one trick to make money investing? Like to get profits investing? Like there is no one trick. But here in terms of weight loss, the trick is motivation. It's outside of what people usually look for. People usually think that there is some diet or some like way, but it's actually not. And problem is motivation is such like a liquid untouchable topic. You cannot really pinpoint it, and you can't really teach someone to find motivation. Like there is no single way. But what it boils down to is that people enjoy food. They enjoy eating. They have habits. They get pleasure. Like you get pleasure from consuming food. You get dopamine release from consuming high fat, high sugar foods, high calorie foods, basically all the junk which kills you. And you need to find something which can rival that. You need to find something which you will value at least at the same degree or more than your food habits, than whatever you're doing. Because yes, absolutely, the diet helps. The diet, the methods, they are important. But once you have this motivation thing dialed in, you will find the ways, you will find the methods. It's going to be easy for you. So the key is to focus not on, like, if you struggle with weight loss, if you try it, it doesn't work. That means that your current habits, your current like way of eating, your current preferences, they all are more valuable to you in truth than health and than proper body. So you just need to, what do you do? Like, you will start looking for tips and tricks and all these diets and all these things. But what you should really focus upon is not on that. You should focus on actually finding what will motivate you, what will make it a must for you to eat clean, to eat proper foods and to lose weight or to like stay healthy and so on and so forth. And for some people, it might be intellectual. For some people, it might be more emotional. Like, for example, you can just study all the ways that sugar basically destroys your body, all the ways that fast food and all this industry like created high palatable foods, how they break your body and natural systems, how they turn you into a slave where you are like doing what you know is wrong for you, but you keep doing it. You can study this and maybe like the logic of this, the understanding of how the process in your body work, maybe that will be the trigger. You can also go for emotional like side, like study basically the health, like what it leads to, what certain ways of eating lead to, like just get horrified by what you will look like inside if you have extra visceral fat. Get horrified, like how pitiful existence will it be when you're old and very unhealthy because of your habits, and when you're like completely like ruined because of your choices, and you have all these health issues, diabetes, whatever. Maybe again, think about how cool it would be to look at yourself in the mirror every day and see the abs, see this definition of the muscle, and like know that you did it. Like, yeah, I did it. I'm a man. Or whatever. Like, for the girl, it would be like, I'm sexy. I'm so like looking so good looking and stuff. Don't spend time like trying to force yourself to eat better, whatever. If you can, of course, but spend time not looking for diets, for tips. Spend time looking for motivation. Spend time looking for things which can make it important for you, which can make it a must for you to change the way you eat, to change the way you diet, to start exercising. Everyone is different. Like, maybe you will care how you look, maybe not. Maybe like play in a Photoshop of your picture, like take your picture naked and like tweak it a bit to look like pretty. Maybe you'll just get like attracted to this, like to the idea that you can look like that. Maybe again, just spend like an hour thinking about how would your life be if you were like eating like this all the time and you're like 60 years old, you're like a walking corpse, I don't know. Or if you're like 70 years old and you're active and fit and you can play with your kids, your grandkids, you can easily like stand up, sit down, you're like all this mobile. Just walk around, look at people, like look at people who made bad choices, where that led them, that made good choices, like how do they look, how do they live. In this day and age of the internet, there is so much motivation online, where you can find people from all sorts of like backgrounds and stuff posting online, and you can see these pictures like of fit 80, 90 years old people who still exercise, who are still like running, lifting weights, who look like amazing even though they have like gray hair and wrinkles, but they are still like living active fit lives. It's awesome. It really motivates you that you can be like that. Maybe, maybe it doesn't. All right, I'm gonna try this dish right here. This scrambled eggs with some prosciutto fungi and greens and all the stuff here. It's actually quite good, surprisingly. I thought there's too much greens in here. Yep. This is basically pizza topping of prosciutto and fungi and chili peppers, just put into scrambled eggs. Basil as well from the pizza. Just wanted to make a simple dish today. Yep. I cook almost all the food I eat, so I'm basically, oh my god, the lighting here. The lighting here doesn't really serve this dish well. Like at home, I can set up the proper lighting, but here it looks like yellow on the stream. Oh my god. Yep. Ah, so those are my haters. Welcome back. How should I call you? Haters or trolls? Whatever. The channel is already up, actually. I just need to release recipes on it. When I'm back home, I can start recording proper like intro, outro, and then the recipes will be there. So let's try with some mayonnaise. I think it's gonna be delicious with the mayonnaise here. Yeah, this is awesome. Like, it's so simple, yet so tasty. And just the right amount of spice. I'm actually in the middle of things now, so I'm trying to transition to this thing full time eventually. I have my other sources of income and stuff. I did a lot of stuff in the background, like in the small side hustles and stuff, and I did many professions, like I was a programmer, I managed a sushi joint, all sorts of stuff. Holy crap. I'm guess I'm gonna go back on topic then and ignore this thing. It's fun to have your haters, like it means you're actually like up a level in popularity, because when nobody notices you, that means nobody is interested. When you have someone notice you, you get someone to hate you as well. So that's like a step up, in my opinion. So yeah, motivation then. It's very individual, but the key is to look for it. Like, the key is to dedicate your time to proper like things. What you focus on will grow. So if you focus on finding your motivation, eventually you will find your motivation. It's like inevitable. Inevitable. Is it working? Yes. You just have to spend time on it. You don't have to expect it. It's gonna come. Like, pay attention to the world around you, to what you're doing, and study the information, study nutrition, study all this like information, how the food works, how your body works, all the information about health issues, diseases, like longevity and stuff. Get inspired by different things. Like, get inspired by videos and films, whatever. Just try to find whatever fits you. Like, one thing that initially inspired me to, you know, build muscle was actually seeing whatever that was, Shades of Grey movie with my wife, where the actor who plays the role of the male, he like slowly raises up doing a pull-up, and he's like so, he looks so good there, and it like caught into my head, like, oh my god, I want to look like that, I want to do that. And the second part was where I got in a situation on the street where I would probably have to fight, and I was naturally scared because I knew that the opponent has bigger muscles and probably can knock me out easily and dominate me. And I was like, I don't want to be scared in my city when facing someone not from my city. I don't want to be scared. I want to be like strong and powerful and feel the proper like power within me to fix that, to solve any conflict if need be with force. So it's individual, but when you study it, when you just try to look for things like that, you will catch something which is yours. Same thing with like abstaining from sugar, abstaining from caffeine. If you don't have a reason, you won't. Like, if you don't have a reason to like abstain from sugar, to go sugar free, you won't go sugar free. That's the fact. You will crave, you will cave in, you will binge, you will start eating sugar. Again. It's not enough to like read an article which says, oh, sugar is bad for you, sugar is like cancer, stop eating sugar. You have to believe it. And to believe it, you have to study it until you actually understand. Like, until it starts to connect with you that yes, sugar is killing you. Until then, you're going to be like, oh, it's just nonsense. Oh, I can cut a little bit on sugar, but still like be safe. But after you thoroughly study it and you understand that there is no way, you understand how sugar metabolizes, how fructose metabolizes, how your liver is getting this pressure when you eat so much fructose, you understand all this, and then it kind of clicks in your head and you're like, what am I doing to my body? Why? Another thing you can do is like just try this as an experiment. So don't like force yourself, don't like commit to a diet for a long time. Just try to like figure out some health improvement you can make and stick to it like for a week, just as an experiment. Oh, the cat is here. Non-inflatable cat, the real cat. And try to stick to it for some time and just see if the benefits will motivate you. For some things, like for the sugar foods, after you have past like several days of the initial cravings, you will really start to feel better. And maybe that will motivate you. You'll go, okay, I can actually feel better if I don't eat these foods. How wonderful. Really, scrambled eggs, quite tasty, with proper sauces. I'm surprised. When the haters left, no fun when you ignore them, I guess. Maybe I should have entertained them a little bit more. Yep, this is definitely good. Simple, but good. Very good. And the spiciness is just nice. For some reason in this dish, the chili pepper, it kind of flourishes and gives all the spice better than in the pizza. I don't know why. So yeah, the problem with trying diets is that unfortunately most diets, you need to stick to them for some time to really see the benefits, because your body adapts. And you might only feel the negatives at first, like the keto diet, which I'm following, low carb, high fat, moderate protein. In this diet, at first you will feel like shit. You will be like drowsy and weak while your body adapts. You will have keto flu probably. You will have headaches. So it's not really like, you won't really feel better immediately on some diets, unfortunately. You will have to stick through initial process, but for some tweaks to your diet, yes, absolutely, you can feel the benefits immediately. Problem is, for most like really important parts, you have to get worse before you get better. Like I was getting off caffeine, it was a nightmare. Just like Alex Becker said in his videos, just a nightmare. Like, I was a caffeine addict. I found it out because I just noticed how I'm increasing my consumption, how I'm like weak until I get caffeine in the morning, and how I just, like, as I said, increase more and more in the amount I consume. I didn't even know it's in the black tea at that time and in the green tea. So not only I was consuming a lot of coffee and energy drinks, but also the tea was also with caffeine, chocolate also on caffeine. And so I decided I need to cut caffeine and tea. And just like Alex Becker explained, just like most people experience who are caffeine addicts, like first 2 to 3 days, it's complete nightmare. Your head aches, you're like, basically you're fucked. You're destroyed. You're just destroyed. And then like a week or two, you have so low motivation, don't have any pleasure, don't want to do anything. And then like for a month, so last 2 weeks, it's better, but still you are like unmotivated, drowsy, you don't want to do stuff. You have to force yourself. And then you see the benefits. Like then, after you're out of this experience, you're like, oh my God, now I have clear focus, energy, and without caffeine. So what I had before, only after I drink caffeine, now I have it at all times. It's so amazing. But first, you have to go through hell. 2 to 3 days of hell, then a month of less, like, but still hell. And then you're completely off caffeine. That's when you get the benefits. So unfortunately, this might not work for all. in terms of dieting, but just generally, if you spend your time properly, if you spend your time not looking for quick fixes, not looking for quick ways to lose weight or whatever, but looking for motivation, like why for you it's a must, and detailed, like exact motivation to be exact state. That's scrambled eggs with prosciutto and fungi and other tasty stuff. Actually, the lighting here doesn't do this dish justice because I'm at a temporary apartment in Tula. I'm gonna have to like wait until I'm back home when I can introduce proper lighting here. This week I'm traveling back to St. Petersburg and then I'm gonna stream at regular intervals and I will have proper like equipment and stuff. So hopefully my food will look appropriately on the stream. Right now it's like yellowish, but it's actually not supposed to be that way. Thank you very much for following. Welcome to the stream and where you're from, by the way. So yeah, if you keep focused on the right stuff and if you keep looking for exact like reasons and exact like state you want to be in, that's how you find your motivation. Like it's not only important to, oh, from Scotland. Yeah, I'm from Russia, St. Petersburg, but right now I temporarily live in Tula. We are visiting my wife's parents. And so I have a smaller apartment here. Don't have all my equipment with me. Still trying to stream, but very soon I'll be back in my apartment and next week I will have a stream schedule properly, like I will stream properly at set intervals, hopefully at regular like intervals. That's gonna be awesome, can't wait to do that. But for now I have to enjoy my time here, so trying to cook whatever I can with limited equipment, and it's still quite tasty actually. Aglio e olio, what is it? I don't know what it is. Olio is oil, probably. So please enlighten me what it is. So yeah, you have to have like exact idea what you want to become. Like olive oil and garlic pasta. Yeah, sounds delicious. I love olive oil, I love garlic and I love pasta. But I didn't like cook a keto pasta yet. I didn't try it yet. I have some recipes ready for a keto pasta. I have my like shirataki noodles, which are like pasta which is zero calories. So they are not only keto, but they are like completely devoid of calories. Well, not really. It's like 1 gram of carbohydrates per huge bowl of pasta. It's really wonderful. It's called miracle noodles for the reason, because it's a miracle that you have noodles which have no calories in them. But admittedly, of course, the taste is a little bit strange to them. Obviously, they're not real pasta. So I tried them, but I'm also gonna try to make some keto pasta when I'm back home. And then I can have all this pasta I love, yeah. I mostly like carbonara and, you know, what else is that? Bolognese. But I'll try that, I'll Google that. It seems to be quite interesting idea. Like garlic, hell yeah. Olive oil, yep. So I guess the mix will also work for me. Let's try some sweet and sour sauce here. So about motivation, it's not that you like have to be motivated to lose weight in general, because again, that's not clear. That's like not, you have to have a clear idea in your mind where you're going. That's when it's going to click and work. Like have specific idea, specific body type, specific ability, specific like breakpoints you want to achieve, and have them really click with you on a deeper level. Like for me, it really clicks on a deeper level to live to 120 years. I know you might say it's silly, like unrealistic, but I want to live to 120 years old. And I'm going to do everything I can to get there. I'm studying nutrition, I'm studying health, I'm studying longevity. I'm gradually taking steps to increase my longevity, to fix all my health issues, to prevent them, to like lead a healthier lifestyle and so on and so forth. Because that thinking motivates me. I want to do it. I want to play with my grandchildren. I want to see them. I want to play with them. I want to be able to jump with them, run after them, not be like this old man with a stick who's like, or even worse, in a wheelchair. So I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do all I can to do it. By the way, how's it going right now in Scotland? I have been there, I've been to Edinburgh. I basically went around all the United Kingdom, Scotland, Ireland, the island which is part of United Kingdom visa, and of course England, like London and neighboring cities. But it's been like several years since I've been there. Way before Brexit and all this stuff happened. I remember Limerick actually the most, like from all my trips to Scotland, I think. Yeah, I know it's like a surprise. Like I heard that it's very like bad weather there, like very little sun, a lot of rain. Basically they say St. Petersburg, where I'm from in Russia, has kind of the same weather, where it's little sun, a lot of like rain or just clouds. I like it. I don't really like get depressed, but many people get depressed in such weather. They go like, oh, how do you live here? So depressing. So little sun. Yeah, this dish is way better with sauces, definitely different sauces on it, just expound the flavor so much, so good. And yes, the idea is you don't go for like typical staples like six-pack abs or like sexy body if you're a woman, or like X percent body fat, but you go for your specific like wants and needs. Like I want to be strong, why? To do this and that. I want to be fit, why? To do this and that. I want to like abstain from junk food, why? For this and that. I want to abstain like from whatever kind of nutrient fried foods. I want to keep my nutrients like in check. I want to like eat food which nurtures my body with all the vitamins and minerals. Why? When you have this why, and when it really draws you, that's when it gets easy for you to actually achieve your goals. And that's when you will find ways to do it, you will find your diet, whatever you need. And stick to it. And it has to be personal. It has to be yours. Like it's your personal idea. It may sound silly to others. It may sound insignificant to others. Like, why would you want that? Or like, why is it important? Like so many people say like, oh, just be body positive. Like, why is it important for you? Well, okay, it is. Or like, why do you have to complicate things that much? Like when people find out how I eat, they're like, how can you eat like this? You don't drink beer, you don't like enjoy this and that, like you don't eat bread. Oh my God, it must be so like bad. I'm like, no, it's easy. I just find ways to make the stuff I like want, like keto pizza, I can find a way to do it. But it's so complicated. Why complicate things? Well, because I want to have a healthy lifestyle. And for that, I found like my way and I'm sticking to it. And like for people, diet is is often so hard. It's not because it's hard, it's because they don't have motivation. Again, like, is it hard to go to the toilet? No, you just go and do it. Oh, that's the salmon steak and some garnish from garnish of onions and garlic. It's just there so it doesn't get like cold while I wait for it to be eaten. And it's on this appliance that keeps it hot, which is actually amazing. Like, I never thought about this idea before I started to watch mukbang videos, eating shows, which I'm basically making here. And before that, I didn't know, but now I can't eat without it. It's so delicious. Like when you don't have to wait for your food, I mean, you don't have to eat your food quickly. Your food is still delicious, still hot, waiting for you. It's so good. Oftentimes I would have to eat faster because the food will get cold, or I would have to carry it to the microwave to heat it up a bit again. This way it's here, it's hot, it's awesome. Like it's simply a lifesaver. So there's this difference between something being hard and taking effort. Like, of course it takes effort to change your dietary habits, to abstain from certain tasty foods, whatever, to lift weights, to work, whatever. But it doesn't have to be hard. When something is hard, when you are literally like suffering doing something, that means the motivation is not there. Like you're trying to push yourself somewhere, but your body resists it because your body is like, why are you doing this? It's bad. Or like, why are you doing it? It's a waste of time. Go do this instead. So for example, if you procrastinate, like you watch YouTube videos or like play computer games instead of doing like some work, that's because your body got hijacked by these activities. Your body thinks it's better to do games than to do work. If you wouldn't have these games distracting your body would want to do the work. And your body would easily go and work. It could take effort to work, physical effort or like mental effort, but it won't be this like issue. It's same everywhere in life. It's same with weight loss, with diet. Once you have this clear mental image of where you're going, that's when it stops being hard and just becomes work. You have to do, like cook your meals or like find ways to cook your meals or like find ways to change your meals or change your habits so you eat different kinds of foods from now on. Maybe like find ways to organize your life so you have time to cook. Find ways to organize your life so you have your food with you, because you cannot like afford to go to the restaurant all the time. You don't have time or money, or you just want to have it easier on yourself, and so on and so forth. But it all starts with you being motivated and you having a clear path, clear goal in front of you, and then the path will come. The how will come when why exists. And all you have to do is literally spend time looking for what will motivate you, what will be your why, what will be your like reason I can't go without it. This is an awesome sauce. Walton Farms. It's on iHerb. I get it on iHerb in Russia because it's not sold in Russia. It's 0 calories, so you can put it in any diet, anywhere you want. Of course, it's not as good as your typical barbecue sauce, but it's still so good because you can add it anywhere. Like, you don't have to even care how much you consume because it's 0 calories. And they make it natural way, so they make the sauce, then they remove the calories, and so the aroma and flavor is mostly natural, and it really shows. Like, I delight in making all these fake foods myself, where aroma and flavor and colors create this illusion of taste, but it's good when it's natural. It's actually quite a relief, and you still feel the difference when it's natural flavors. So if you just dedicate like certain amount of time a day to finding your why, to studying nutrition, health, to looking for examples, like looking at Instagram of celebrities, whatever, fitness celebrities, or like just figuring out like why could you need this, why could this work for you, then you're gonna actually like find it. Unfortunately, people don't do it. People like ask me all the time, should I quit sugar, or like should I try this or that, or like what diet would you suggest for me, or like is this bad for you, is it good for you, does it work? And it's the wrong way to go. Like, it's not the way to go. It's not what leads to progress, because these people are the people who struggle with weight loss usually, and they don't like understand this. They don't understand, they don't have motivation to lose weight. They go from one fix to the other. One diet to the other, and it doesn't work for them. Okay, time to have this steak right here. Yeah, this lightning doesn't do it justice at all. It's supposed to be this red and very deliciously looking one. It's kind of yellow on the screen in front of me. It's insane. Let's see if the onion is properly cooked. Nice. Still hard to put on the fork, but it's very nice. Yeah, but it doesn't. These plastic forks, man. We don't have our dishwasher here, obviously, low-touch flat, so we decided with my wife we will like use plastic tableware as much as possible, so I'm trying to honor that, but it just doesn't work. Well, I try to make it work. Anyways, let's dive right in. Oh, thank you very much for following. Well, no. The onions are different. Like, there is shallot onions. There are shallot onions, white onions, red onions. In Russia, they distinguish between yellow and white onions. I don't know. I don't feel the difference. But they kind of distinguish between white and yellow as well. And we also have some special kind of red onion, which costs like 5 times as expensive. It's supposedly from Yalta, a region in Russia, and I also don't see the difference. But between red and white, there are differences. Yes, the taste is different, the bite is different. Also, it's very important how you cook it. Like if you put it in water or if you fry it, it kind of changes dramatically how it tastes and feels. Anyways, thank you for the follow. Welcome to the stream, where you're from. Yeah, this steak is delicious. It's simply delicious. Well, I mean, it should be. Quite an expensive cut of fish. Quite an expensive fish as well. Like, at home, I have all these suppliers back from my sushi management time, which I order foods from. It, like, saves almost twice the amount of money to buy from them. For some reason, in the shop, the fish is so expensive in Russia. But this thing is so good for you, so nutritious, like omega-3 and calcium and all sorts of stuff in this fish. Definitely should eat it weekly. Oftentimes, it's also like a problem that, again, we are all bad at science and we are all bad at actually challenging our opinion. Like, the scientific mindset is where you try to prove you're wrong all the time. So you have to, like, look for ways to find that your logic is wrong, your idea is wrong, your proposal is wrong. And when you know it's not there, like you found several ways to test your theory, it still stands, that's when you say, okay, probably it's right. But common human, like, way of thinking, of course, is different. We like to be right, we like to be, like, correct, and so we're only looking for ways to confirm that we are correct, and we're trying to, like, shove aside all the stuff which shows us we're wrong. Same with diet. Like, people all the time ask me, and you see how, like, I'm gonna put this on the heater back so it's hot while we talk. I see how they're, like, looking for specific answer. Like, they want to hear it's okay to eat sugar. They want to hear it's, like, okay to, like, eat whatever food they like. They want to look for this answer because they want it to work this way. And you say to them, I'm sorry, no. Like, ah, I see. And you understand that, okay, they're gonna go ask someone else the same question. And they're looking for someone who will tell them that, yes, you can do it. I did the same. I read a book about carbs backloading. It's basically a strategy where you eat a lot of carbohydrates after you exercise, like physical weightlifting. And I took that as an indulgence to consume loads of sugar, even though the book specifically said no sugars, no sugars, no sugars many times. When I reread the book after several years, after I changed my approach to diet, I was like, how can I miss that? It says several times that you don't eat sugars. You eat carbohydrates, yes. You eat fast carbohydrates, high glycemic index, yes, but you don't eat sugars. You eat, like, starches. So, clean, good pasta and stuff. But I read what I want to read. I read part of it. I liked it. It fit my idea. I discarded the rest. And people work that way. And again, motivation is what fixes this. Because when you have motivation, you will try to find a way. Oh, thank you very much. 1 second, it's still late on my stream. Thank you very much, Mikey, for following. Welcome to the stream. When you have your motivation, you will have your motivation to change the way you think, because you will logically go, okay, I want this result, I don't have it, so that means I have something wrong. I have to change something to get the result. But before that, you will just keep like looking for answers you want to look for. You keep looking for answers that comfort you, that fit with your idea. And of course, that's not a progress. That's not gonna help you at all. One second. And all the information you find, all the reasons you find, they should come down to something which is dear to you. Like again, you might find that sugar is bad for you. You might read an article, okay, but you have to really understand, you have to really believe it. Like even if you understand the scientific data, if you're a scientist, you have to accept it. And for that you have to really like dig deeper and find connection to it. Like connect to it on some sort of intimate level, you know? Don't know how to say it, but when you're like really connected to it. Like in love with the idea. That's when you really start to believe it, accept it, and that's when you start to live after this idea. But yes, problem is it's very individual and it's up to you. Like there is no way to teach this. There is no way to sell this as a course. Teach this, like you just have to find it yourself. There are certain like programs, mostly in self-development area, which can help it. Like Tony Robbins, he likes to work with like your values. So you write out your values, you structure them according to importance. Then you can see, like for example, you speak about you want to go on a diet, but your health is not even present in your values. Your values are like security, pleasure, happiness, whatever, but health is not there. You're like, no shit, you don't get healthy. You don't value health. You might say you do, but when you figure out like how many things you value above it, it's like so low down the list, it's basically non-existent. Other approaches. My bottom line is, it's something personal. And the worst part, as I talked about in the last video, is that when you get it, oftentimes you don't understand that what worked was motivation, not specific diet, not specific like life hack, not specific like idea, like specific way to eat, specific way to exercise. And all these gurus, teachers, trainers, coaches out there who are fit, healthy, and who sell books and programs, most of them are not charlatans. They genuinely believe that they found the program that works. They say, okay, I went through countless problems with weight loss. I tried this, and that. I suffered. Now I found the way to do it. Here it is. It works for me, works for my clients. It'll work for you. And they sell it. And when it doesn't work for some of their clients, they go, oh, he was not like committed. He like didn't follow the rules. He like, of course he didn't follow the rules. That's the problem with the diet. All diets, almost all diets work. It's all about following them. The following them is the key part, the problem part. Like, Atkins works, keto works, low fat, high carb works, intermittent fasting works, whatever. Noon works, whatever else, like almost any sort of diet which is not like outrageously stupid, like vodka and ice cream, which is possible, by the way. There is a video on YouTube, a person cataloged, like vlogged his month of his life where he lost weight on vodka and ice cream. Can be done. There is a video where a person cataloged, like made a log of his journey where he lost weight and got healthier on McDonald's. He only ate McDonald's every day for like a month or so. And in the end, he did his blood work, his body scan. He was more healthy than before he started. So it's possible. Yeah, so these people, they think they found the diet, the way to eat, the course. No, they found the motivation. And oftentimes this becomes like a self-fulfilling prophecy, because once they found the motivation, they got fit, once they decided to earn money from it, and they... yep, that's it. Like, Eric the Electric, he released a video, like last one of his videos, where he ate like 5,000 calories McDonald's every day for a week. So 5,000 calories of crap food every day for a week, gained no weight, simply because he cycled for like 6 hours. So he went on a bicycle, he ran 6 miles, like 6 hours, tens of miles, dozens of miles track, and he burnt all the calories. That's it. That's because he has a motivation. Like, this shit pays for his bills, this shit earns him money, so he has to do it, so he does it. Like, he said how bad he felt, how it was terrible, he almost got no sleep and stuff, but he did it because he was motivated to do it, because that's what makes him like earn his money to pay the bills and to enjoy the life he has. So, Deki, if you are willing to share, if you're okay, you can share, like, what did you try in terms of diet and what exactly does not work for you? Like, what do you mean by not working? Maybe I can help. Try some mayonnaise on this fish. Yep, definitely a good fit here. Have to finish all the leftovers I have before I go back to my city. So this homemade mayonnaise and stuff. But it's also very delicious, so no problem. You can add it almost everywhere. Okay, yes. Yep, so you tried. And what's the result? So do you consume the same amount of calories of healthy snacks in the end? Or do you like, have you replaced your snacks with low calorie options, but you don't see any change on the scale, like the weight stays the same regardless of what you eat? Definitely going to be making more of these. Very good. so simple but so good. Like sometimes you want some pizza, pasta, something complicated like a burger, lasagna, whatever. Sometimes just simple steak with a fish with some simple vegetables. It's so delicious. Like just quickly cook it, eat it. It's amazing. Yep. Well, again, yes, all these things can work. I have a treadmill under my PC, so at home, like even here, you might see right there, my PC is in the top like corner. I don't know if it's gonna be visible like so. So I have my PC like quite high, so I work at a standing desk at home. I don't like work sitting. So while I work, the PC is high. I have to stand in front of it and I have a treadmill under it. So if I can, I run or walk. If I cannot, I just stand there. But that helps a lot to get extra exercise, and basically it's more healthy to stand than to sit. Sitting is literally killing humanity. Like there's a book about it. The book is terrible. The book is very badly written, but the book is the truth. Like the information there is invaluable, because literally sitting is killing us as humanity. That's pure and simple. Not only is sitting like harmful to your body, because it's like not a proper posture. Like right now, I sit cross-legged on the floor. That's a way healthier posture than sitting in a chair. In the chair, when you sit, there are so many things going wrong with your body, but also it's kind of a mental, like bodily thing, which triggers the wrong signals. Like basically, the most basic way to say this is that you are here because your father and mother reproduced. So that's how selection works, natural selection. What reproduces gets spread in the next generation, survives. What didn't reproduce is forgotten. And so, two ways people reproduced was either by going strong, alpha, like dominating, getting their stuff like by force, being active, or by covering in fear, like hiding in the crowd, like this gray, I'm nothing, don't touch me, and surviving that way, and somehow like reproducing that way. And so when you sit in the chair all the day, you trigger these wrong patterns, like you trigger those memories of the wrong way of living and reproducing. You trigger all these associations in your body which tell you to be small, insignificant, hide, don't strive for anything, don't go for anything, just enjoy what you have, be patient, be content with what you have. So it's kind of like your whole body is shutting down into this state when you sit. When you stand upright, when you like spread your arms like this, that's where you trigger the different processes in your body, different memories, like of the conqueror, of the person who goes and wins in life, who like takes what is rightly his by force and might, who develops and so on and so forth. And yep, treadmill is amazing. If you can work standing or moving, that's pure, like that's very good. But again, not everybody can do it. Like if your profession demands you to sit, unfortunately no. Like, if you're like a programmer, you can work standing if your workplace permits it, or if you work at home. But like, if you're a dentist, sorry, no, you have to sit in the chair. But yeah, treadmill is very good if you can integrate it into your life. And studies show that we remember more, we understand more when we move. Like if you just sit and watch some educational movie, or you walk and watch it, walking and watching it will be more beneficial. You will remember more, you will understand more, and you will basically get more out of it. Some bones in there. But again, unfortunately, without motivation and clear goals and willingness to adapt, it's not gonna go anywhere, because your body can adapt very well. Like for example, you buy a treadmill and you start using it, burning calories. Your body will find ways to eat a bit more, or like rest a bit more at different times of the day. You will end up with the same amount of calories burned versus consumed. Or like you start lifting weights and then you're like, oh, I lift weights, now I need to eat more to gain muscle. So your body tricks you into eating more calories. Or you exercise and you're tired and you come home after the exercise and you're like, oh, I'm gonna just relax. So if before at home you were active in the evening, now you're like watching TV. And this way the body can adapt to whatever like extra calories you spend, or whatever less calories like you consume, you restrict, the body can adapt. And basically, again, that's why people have plateaus on weight loss, because the body adapts. So if you don't have a clear motivation to keep pushing, whatever you like tip or trick you do, it will get a little bit of result and then it's gonna stop giving you results. But of course, the more the better. Like, the more options you give to your body to burn calories, the better. So if you can have a treadmill, like if you can afford it, and if you can integrate it into your part of your life, yes, definitely worth it. And you don't have to like force yourself. Again, every little helps. So if you can, get it. Like if you can introduce more walking into your life, less sitting, get it. If you can like walk while listening to music, do it. Maybe you don't need the treadmill, maybe you can just walk outside, do it. It will help, like it will change your attitude. Sure. In the end, all comes down to motivation. When you have it, everything else will work. And until you do, you just better spend some time of your day. Just don't force yourself to like change something. Just watch videos, just watch YouTube, just like watch Instagram, social media, but not like what you usually do, but go for something like about health, about fitness. Find something that will inspire you. Maybe you find someone who looks like just like you, but he's like 30 years older, he has a better body, and you're like, I want to look like that in 30 years. Maybe you find someone who is like sick and like maybe some rich person, but he's sick. And you go like all the riches in the world doesn't help you if you're that sick, if you're like in that bad state of health. Maybe read about all the suffering which bad health issues lead to, and you go like, I don't want to have that. Like literally, like, you know how they like in Russia there's this idea where parents would bring their smoking kids into a morgue and show them the lungs of a patient who died of like lung cancer to shock them. But this can work. Like, shock yourself. Look in the face of the reality. Look in the face of the reality of living way like less prosperous, way less enjoyable life. Like a life full of misery in the end, where you basically don't want to die, but you don't want to live anyways because your life is so horrible. And say, no, I don't want that. Some bones in this fish still get to me. Like, I know how to fillet the fish, how to cut the fish for sushi. I did it myself. I know where the bones are. I still sometimes miss them when I eat it. Should know better. Maybe volunteer for some like patient care. Just several hours or several days. Just to meet this, to face this, this reality. Study which diseases like it leads to when you eat like you currently do if you have problem with changing your diet. Study like this cause of death, like how prevalent it is. Study like biographies of some people who died of it, who are like renowned or well known. And again, become afraid of it, become sick of it, like, I don't want this for me. Okay, that's over. This steak. Yep, definitely. Like, sometimes it's good to figure out tasty junk food, healthy. Like, that's what I like to do. I really like to cook junk food, which is not junk anymore. To food swap the ingredients to make it like healthy and shit. But sometimes it's good to just have some simple dish which is just tasty, just good for you. No hassle, no like complicated stuff. Just have it and enjoy it. Okay, well, quickly, be right back with my ice cream. Thank you. another benefit of living a healthier lifestyle. I enjoy cold showers, and so when we lost our hot water for several days, what's up? Yeah, everything's fine. Die Goblin King, thank you very much. Unfortunately, the mukbang is mostly over. I only have my dessert left. But thanks you for coming in. Thank you for joining the stream. So yeah, we have our hot water randomly cut for several days. In too late happens all the time. And I'm like, what's the deal? My wife is like, I cannot wash. I'm like, ah, of course. I'm just used to cold showers. And she's like, oh, I'm gonna get sick. I'm gonna like cough and stuff. Yeah. Finally, the water is back, but it's cold. So now we have cold water and a water which is a bit less cold than cold water to choose from. Amazing. Anyways, this ice cream is simply the best because it's so low calorie. Like I keep saying it, but I will say it again. Just delicious, just amazing, and only like 20 calories in the whole stick. And you can eat it for like 5-6 minutes slowly. It's so delicious. Granted, this is not like the recipe exactly, because you don't have erythritol here in Tula. It's very expensive in the shops. Yep, it was. You can watch the replay or the video on YouTube when it's out. But today, unfortunately, like to this moment, only the ice cream remains. This ice cream is just amazing. Like I tried my best to make it as low calorie as possible and still to have it like an ice cream, not ice, and it surprisingly worked. But it only works in popsicles, so it's still quite hard, not convenient to spoon with a spoon. But in a popsicle, you just take it out of the freezer, put it under the hot water, which I don't have, put it under hot water for several seconds, and then you can take it out and enjoy it. And you enjoy it very slowly. It slowly melts in your mouth. You have all the sensations of eating ice cream. All this enveloping fat and the sweetness, because it has inulin and xanthan gum. And inulin kind of tricks your like receptors in the mouth to think it's fat, while it's not. Like you feel like you consume fat because it envelops your mouth, but actually it's almost zero calorie. It's like 1 calorie per gram or less in the inulin. So I feel like you eat something full of fats and carbs, but actually there's like 1 gram of fat and 3 grams of protein in this whole popsicle. That's it. Here I have coffee. Again, I only have little amount of flavors with me. Back in St. Petersburg, I have this library of flavors. Like, my wife has these huge walls of perfume, different like aroma, different like styles, different notes, flavors. And then I have this, the same amount of flavors, but for food. So it's like food flavorings and aromatics. So this is coffee. I only have several flavors with me here. But at home I do whatever I want. Like I just come to the drawer, open it, and like choose what taste I want to have. It's really amazing. Like what I showed on the last stream, you can take Greek yogurt or like liquid quark, if you have quark in your region. It's mostly like a dish which is popular in Eastern Europe, in Russia, and CIS countries, like past USSR countries. It's basically something like cottage cheese, curd cheese. It can also be liquid, like yogurt. And so you take that, add flavorings, add colorings, maybe a little bit of like cut berries or like a little bit of some fruit. Just a tiny bit for the texture. You mix it and you have this wonderful dessert, which is literally like big bowl of dessert which is like creamy and tasty and sweet and delicious, which is only like 50 or 70 calories per whole dessert. It's amazing. And you just have to stock on Greek yogurt or quark, and then you can make whatever taste you want. So take it out, add whatever, mix it, and you have whatever you want, like on demand. It's amazing. With ice cream, I make a big batch of it. I separate it into parts, add different flavors and colors, and freeze it. Then again, I have on demand what I want from the freezer. It's awesome. But I'm still perfecting the recipe. But once I'm back, I'm gonna make a stream where I'll show the correct recipe and how it should look properly done. And then I'm gonna probably go on experimenting again. Like, I can't stop experimenting. Sometimes I'm like, this should be good enough, but I want to try this thing and this thing, and it goes on. So I want to make a lot of it just to save time, but then I want to make it a little bit to test something new. And the idea for this ice cream came from Hello Top, which is a brand available in America, I believe in Europe. Unfortunately, in Russia it's not available, but it's like highly touted as the best low-calorie ice cream. So I just went for the nutrition label, for the ingredients, just tried to put them together and see if it works. And eventually it started working. And then I found out that you can go even lower in calories than they do, and it still tastes amazing. Then again, I might try some keto ice cream, which is high in fats but no carbs. See how that goes. But with desserts, the great benefit to what I do is I have desserts which are so low in calories, I can just eat unlimited amounts of them, nearly unlimited. And so you can just enjoy whatever you want when the meal is finished until you feel full. So you don't have to like stop yourself, say stop, it's enough. You can eat if you want, you can eat more. And then your body just sends the signal it's full eventually from the whole meal you had before. And so you stop eating without any restraining yourself specifically. But yeah, this thing is a lifesaver. Fits into almost any diet. And so delicious, so tasty, and so low calorie. So yeah, luckily, nowadays, there is so much information online that it's really easy to find your motivation when you think of it. Because you have access to all these people, to all these, like, we literally have access to private lives of successful people, which is something we never had before. Like, before, a successful person was isolated from us. He was like different caste, in a different castle, far away. You know, like this peasant right here in the field. There is no way you even understand how he thinks, how he looks, how he works, how he does it. But now, with social networks, all these books and stuff, we get access to it. So we can actually get so much information about what works for people, what people get motivated by, how people get where they get to. Yes, of course, people can lie and people can be wrong. about why they're successful, but you still get all this information available. So it's easy to spend time every day, just check on it and look for something which works for you. It just has to be the correct search query. So look for something which motivates, not something that works for weight loss. Oh shit, okay. Oh my god, this doesn't want to come out properly. This is a disaster. Okay, I'll have to eat through the spoon then. Like this. Works too. I guess. Yep, it works, but it's strange. And if every day you study the topic and you look for something which is yours, you will find something which is yours. You will get an idea, an inspiration, something, and eventually it's gonna lead you to finding your why, like why you need it. Like, it's good to have these small tweaks and changes, but when you have your why, it's gonna change dramatically. Like, everything will be this razor sharp path to victory. Like focus in one line. Everything will fall into place. Like, everything will fall into this sort of jigsaw puzzle that connects, and there's a clear picture. It's such a dramatic change. And here again, we come to the problem of capitalism. Nobody's interested in you finding ways like to improve yourself, which basically nobody is interested in you saving money, because that's bad for capitalism. So if you find motivation, you will need way less products. You will be way less like wasteful. You will not waste time, you will just go and do it. You will not need some like comfort foods, some comfort shopping, like to comfort you in your like dismay, in your like depression. You will be focused, determined, you will go and do your stuff. You won't need like supplements or whatever, like products, consultations. And so it's bad for capitalism if that happens. Unfortunately, it's good for capitalism if you're sad, depressed, sick. Like, the more problems you have, the more reason you have to earn money to spend on those problems. So the economy works. And that's a sad reality. It's not a conspiracy. It's not like some evil plan to make you sick and fat. It's just that to capitalism, you're better when you're sick and fat, when you're unmotivated. Because you can be triggered into desiring all these minute things, entertainments and products, and you can be triggered into working for them and running the economy, being this rat in a treadmill, rat race, to get the money to spend on it. And that's what capitalism cares about, spending money. Money spent is good, money not spent is not good. Gotta get this ice cream out of here. Oh my god, this is a mess. Come on. Like, it works easily when you can just use hot water. Just use hot water to take it out. But I don't have such option. Because Tula. Okay. Whatever. Use the back of the knife to help yourself. So unfortunately, first thing is that nobody is interested in you finding motivation, because that saves you money and that basically ruins the economy in some way. And second is that since people don't look for it, there is no training for it. Like, people don't actually look for motivation. People look for diet tips, weight loss tips, weight loss hacks, stuff and like that. Very seldom do people look for motivation for weight loss. Like, they might look for like animated videos with some like messages. That's not it, actually it. But what people do look is for products that help, like pills, courses, books, supplements. So naturally, that's what people do, what people sell. Because in capitalism, you sell what's in demand, naturally. So if I make like a video, like 5 tips to lose weight, it will get views. If I make a video like where I explain this motivation thing, it will get less views. Because people look for weight loss tips, weight loss hacks. People don't look for like how do I find my motivation to stick to the diet or stuff like that. Okay, I'm gonna have to read my outro for YouTube. I'm learning this thing. Just give me a second. Hopefully it's gonna be less cringe-worthy than it is before. Like, I'm constantly trying to improve. Right. Yep. So hopefully this is better than last time. Alright. Thank you very much for joining me today. Follow me on Twitch so you can watch me live and interact with me on stream. For those of you watching on YouTube, make sure to click that subscribe button and then click notification bell so that you will be the first one to know when I release another Mock Paying video. And after that, check out this playlist right here for more Mock Paying videos, healthy mock pangs you will definitely enjoy. I love you all, we will see you all again real soon.